Hello everybody, and welcome to the tutorial on how to build the Bank of China Tower. I did a special video, it was my 100th video on this YouTube channel, and I did a sort of build of the skyscraper, and it was pretty cool. I got a ton of requests on doing a tutorial on how to build it, so here it is guys. And throughout this video, I'm gonna try and explain what I do step by step, but it's not gonna be very good. I've already attempted trying to do this live commentary type thing, and it just doesn't seem to kind of, you know, it doesn't make sense. So if I don't really make sense, just try and follow the video as closely as possible, guys. So the materials you're going to need for this build are blocks of quartz. You're going to need quartz stairs, coal blocks, glowstone, glass, quartz slabs, glass panes, and then you're also going to need cyan stained clay. And for the first part of this tutorial, you're going to want to make a 31 by 31 outline in the ground with quartz blocks. This kind of just gives you an idea of where the base of the building is going to be built, and it kind of serves as a borders sort of as well. And so once you got that, you're going to go into the corners just inside the outline, and you're going to make a 2x2 5 tall pillar, and you're going to do that in each corner of the outline. Look at that village. That's a nice village. Okay, and then once you're done doing that, you're gonna do a 3 tall, 5 wide, just on the outside, right on the borders, just on the outside of the pillars, like so. And you're gonna do that in each corner. Just do the same thing. And then you're gonna get your glowstone, and you're going to make columns every other block, starting just on the outside of the walls you just built. And they're actually gonna be 5 high. I do them 4 high here for some reason, I don't know, but it's every other block, one block inside the outline. And then on the border, or on your outline, in between, you're gonna put a 4 tall column of quartz blocks. And then you can go ahead and put in slabs. Make sure the slabs are on the bottom part of the glowstone. And then after 4 columns of glowstone and 1 column after the column of quartz, get rid of 3 columns of glowstone, and it's going to be a gap of 5 blocks, and that's going to be your entrance. And then you're going to just continue putting in slabs on the other side. And then you're gonna make sort of a half slab staircase kind of thing on the corner, like so in the video. And then you're gonna put quartz stairs on top of the quartz columns. And then you're actually gonna do that kind of staircase look on each side in the corners. And then you can go ahead and go all the way across with stairs. Yeah, it's really hard to describe this. It's really weird. It is. It's kind of a weird design, but you know. And then just underneath, right where the entrance is, go ahead and put a row of quartz blocks. And then I actually screw up here. The glowstone doesn't go there. And I realize it. I'm like, wait a minute, this doesn't look right. So I correct myself. And it actually, this is where I go five high on the glowstone. There we go. Good job, Nick. Dang, there are slimes everywhere. That is so annoying when you're doing like just flat land, completely flat. And then on top of the glowstone, you're gonna make a five tall column of just plain old blocks of glass. And again, these can be like any color you want. These can be blue, green, red. I don't know, any like your favorite color. I mean, I just did them clear because when I was building this, they didn't have the colored glass. And then just in between the glowstone, put a block of quartz, just like that. All right, looking good so far. And then we're gonna make sort of a roof kind of thing. Where the entrance is, I don't know what it's called, but it's sort of a roof, and it's gonna go out five blocks, and then on the outside of the glass you're gonna go outside the glass with coal blocks, go all the way down to the other side just like that, and then in between the glass you're gonna fill it in with the same block of coal. Okay. Then once you're done with that, you can go ahead and add on to the 2x2 pillars that we built. And you're gonna go three higher above the blocks of coal, so that it's three taller. And then you can go ahead and extend that all the way to the other side. And you're gonna just connect it to the pillar. And it's gonna be two rows of quartz, just like that. And then in between, you're gonna do glass panes. I kinda wish I would've done them in different colors, just to kinda show you guys. But yeah, I didn't. And then we're gonna make sort of a staircase type looking deal. And it kinda just makes it look like the building is actually supporting the roof thing we just made. Oh man. So you're just gonna kind of do what I do in the video. Just like that. And that's basically your entrance. And then for the other three sides, it's basically the same thing, only you're not gonna have the entrance part, and you'll see here in the video. I'm just raising up the columns or pillars, and then really quickly I just speed through this because it's kind of boring to watch me build this, and this video would be so long. So you're basically just gonna do the same thing, except you're not gonna have an entrance, pretty much. So I'm just kind of showing you guys how to do it again. You know what I just realized? I didn't put glowstone on the corners of the base. That's hilarious. I forgot that. Oh man. But everything else is pretty much good. I actually screw up in this video. And you'll probably catch it. It's towards the end of the video. You might catch it, I don't know. But yeah, I was doing the editing for this and I was like putting it all together, you know. And I realized it. I'm like, wait a minute, that's not right. That's not how you do that. And it's the very top of the building. So you'll probably see it. See, look how cool that is. That is so cool. That's such a cool. I like the base. I like how I did it. It just looks awesome. And I guess how I got that idea of doing like the glowstone and then the half slabs. A while back, I had a Minecraft server and I built this huge bridge in between. There were these giant hills, and I built a bridge connecting the hills. And I sort of built a city inside the this valley in between the hills. And that's the type of design I did for the walls of the city and of the bridge. I did that, and it turned out so cool. I wish I still had that server. That would have been really cool. I actually did a video on it now that I think about it. It was on my YouTube channel I had a couple years ago, but I accidentally deleted that channel on accident. I didn't mean it, and because I was trying to switch my emails from, I think it was like Gmail to Hotmail or vice versa. I don't know. I can't remember which way I was trying to switch, but somehow I deleted my YouTube channel. And I think I had like, I can't remember, I had like 70 subscribers, 70, 80 subscribers, and I had like, I can't remember, like 50 videos, I don't know. But yeah, that was a very sad day. And so that's how this channel came about. This channel was an accident. I'm just kidding. This channel's awesome. I love it. Alright, so now that you're done with the three sides, we're going to add the first set of sort of windows. And so you're going to, on the very corner of the pillars, you're going to go up four, and then you're just going to connect all the corners, just like I do in the video. And then you're gonna leave a 3x3 hole. So you're gonna go up three, you know, just to make 3x3, and that's where we're gonna put our windows or our glass, I suppose. And then you're just gonna go ahead and put your glass in. These can be Any color too if you wanted. I actually wanted these windows to be darker, and that's why I have the cyan stained clay behind it, so that it appears to be like darker glass. But since there's colored glass, you can pretty much make that any color if you wanted to. Okay, and then once you're done with that, I just go ahead and put the stained clay behind the glass, because that's how I did it in the video. So, yeah. Now that I think about it, it kind of looks stupid on the inside, but that's okay. I didn't really care about the inside or the interior of this building. I just wanted to do it for the, you know, exterior, you know? So, because I didn't do an interior for the building, because that would have taken forever. Wow, this building is huge. Okay, and then, basically, you're going to make an X. This part is kind of hard to describe, but you're going to start off in the corner. You're going to go one block in, and you're going to start there. So put down a block, and then you're just going to make an X. And you can kind of follow what I do in the video. And this part takes forever. This was probably the hardest part about this, was making these X's and, you know, the sides of the building. And it was just, it takes forever. But basically, where the entrance, that side is only going to have one X. The left side is going to have, let's see, I can't remember. It's either two or three X's. And then the right side is either going to have two or three. And then the opposite side of the entrance, it's going to have five X's. And I'll actually show you guys in the video. And then once you're done making that X, go ahead and go straight across, connecting the two ends of the X's with just a straight line of quart blocks. And that's basically the X you're going to form. And that's what I kind of mean by the X's. So on the right side of the entrance, and I can't believe I can't remember. I guess we'll find out. I think the right side is two and the left side is three. But I kind of speed it up because... It takes forever to make these X's because you have to do a diagonal, and that's a little bit more tricky in Minecraft, at least. So once you're done making that first X, you can just go ahead and continue that the end, and you're not going to put a straight line across like you did in the front. You're just going to go one block up, and then you're going to continue the X. Okay, yep, the right side is two X's, so there you go. And then once you get done with that second X, just go ahead and go straight across. And with these X's, I put glowstone behind the block inside the building, so it kind of gives it a glow type. Because if you look at real life pictures of the skyscraper, the Bank of China Tower, the sort of X lines, they actually light up, and those are actually lights. So I kind of wanted to do the same thing, so I just went ahead and put glowstone behind, so that you can't really see the glowstone when you're looking at it, but it still gives it that sort of glow. And then on the left side of the entrance, that side, it's going to have three X's. Alright, and then once you're done making those X's, go ahead and make a straight line across at the very top of the third X. And now the back side, which is going to be five X's. Hope you're not afraid of heights, because this building goes above the clouds in Minecraft. How crazy is that? That's real crazy. And then once you're done making that fifth X, go straight across, right on top. And then I'm going to finish doing glowstone behind my X's. So I'm just gonna go ahead and speed through this, just so you guys don't have to watch that, because it's pretty exciting, you know. All right, I'm done with that. Next, we're gonna find the very middle of the building. And then you're just gonna make the biggest noob tower ever. Just straight up. Then once you're done with that, I'm going to show you guys how I sort of made this slant pyramid side type thing. I'm not really sure how to describe it, but if you look at pictures of the building, you'll know what I'm talking about. Like, at the top of each side, it slants towards the middle of the building. That's why we built that tower, or well, column in the very middle. And so basically you're just gonna keep going, make a staircase sort of, and you're just gonna go one in and make sort of a diagonal with the blocks, and that's gonna give it that sort of pyramid type, you know, side. It's very hard to describe. I'm not sure how good I'm doing, but if you just follow what I do in the video, you guys should be fine. And there we go. You're gonna get all the way down to just one block of glass, and that's pretty much how you do it. And you're basically gonna do the same thing for each side of the building, except for the tallest side, which would be the opposite side of the entrance. Don't do that to the very top just yet, because it's a little bit different than what we do with the other three sides. Then once you're done with that, right on those blocks, on the court blocks of the sort of diagonal, you know, pyramid side on the top, you're just gonna go straight up with glass. And that's pretty much how we kind of create that side, sort of on the inside of the building. And then on that same type of wall, you're gonna skip one block and then you're gonna do a diagonal with court blocks. Just like I do in the video. And there you go, it should meet up perfectly. And then you're gonna do the same thing pretty much on the other side, and you might have to get rid of some glowstone. That's okay. And then you're basically gonna do the same thing on whenever you do the insides. You're just gonna make a diagonal, and it's not gonna be an X. It's just gonna be from the middle. You're gonna go to the corner and then gonna go to the middle and then to the corner, and just make these diagonals. And they should line up nicely with the corners. All right, so on the very top, you're gonna kind of do the same thing that you did to the top of the other three sides, where you make that sort of pyramid going to the middle. But what's different is you actually stop about halfway, and then you go back down with glass. And I'll show you guys right here. And I actually just continue up and do it how I did on the other three sides. And it actually rains and thunder. That's cool. It actually is cool. So I did it like that. And then you're gonna count 6 blocks, and on the 7th one, that's the middle. So then you're gonna go diagonally straight, diagonally down to the middle, basically to the noob tower. And you can get rid of that glass going up, but don't get rid of the court blocks. And then you're just gonna go straight across with glass. And this is actually where I screwed up. This is where I was talking about in the beginning. So you're gonna continue from the very top. So on that 7th block in the middle, you're just gonna continue up and make a noob tower. See, that glowstone was not there before. And then you're just basically gonna do a diagonal to those towers. Just like that. And then I think I make it 10 high with quartz, and then I put a piece of glowstone on the top. And boom, there you go. And then you can delete, get rid of the middle part, but not all of it, just starting from the very top of the first side. So on the entrance side, you can go from that down. And then this is where I show you guys sort of a cool design that you can do with the glass. So I use white, red, and blue, cause America. And I do this really cool kind of checkerboard type. Well, not really a checkerboard, but it's sort of like that. And it looks really cool. And this just kind of shows you guys that you can go absolutely crazy with this, cause now that there's colored glass, yeah, you could make so many different cool designs with this. I kind of wish they would have had colored glass when I was making this. That would have looked so... I would have came up with something so cool. But it is what it is. So I really hope you guys have enjoyed this tutorial, and I really hope it was helpful. If you have any questions about anything, go ahead and post the question in the comments and I will read it and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Another thing I didn't do in this tutorial, in the build, in the original video, I put glowstone on the inside, basically on the inside of the corners too, pretty much lighting everything up. So like the X's, the straight across, the corners, I basically lit all of that up and I put glowstone on the inside. And what else did I didn't put glowstone on the corners, at the base, so where the three tall quartz is, at the very corners there should be glowstone there. And I think that's pretty much it, guys. Yeah, this was a really cool design. Look at that. That is so cool. It looks awesome. Yeah, this building is so big. It's unbelievable. And then also you can fill in between the glowstone so it doesn't look so weird on the inside. And maybe I should do interior sometime. I think that'd be really cool. There you go. And I didn't finish filling in because that would take a long time. And this video would be much longer than 40 minutes. So, thanks guys for watching. And no slime were hurt in this video. Just kidding. Alright guys. See you next time.